They love not their lying until they die. You overcame him by the blood. And one of the mysteries in this kingdom that the Lord gave us to overcome is the blood. And I love this scripture so well. The Bible recorded, it said, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. They loved not their life unto the death. You see, one of the major mysteries in this kingdom to avert sudden and untimely death is the blood. The blood of Jesus. The Bible recorded in the Leviticus, it said, the life of the flesh is in the blood. If the blood cannot be attacked, so to say, a life cannot be cautioned. The life of the flesh is in the blood. So tonight, I want to pray for one who said the loudest amen. In the name that is above every other name, I plead the blood of Jesus over me and over everyone here, that in the name of Jesus, the resurrected Lord, every evil against you shall be averted in the name of Jesus. If you're saying amen, you're amen to the Lord and clear. There are seven things I want to show you from the Word of God that is available in the blood before I lead you to pray. Number one, the potency of the blood. There is overcoming power in the blood. I'll share seven. There is overcoming power in the blood. The scripture we read said, they overcame it by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony, they love not their life unto the death. This is to say, we overcome death by the blood. We overcome the arithmetic of the devil by the blood. We overcome the ugly situation around our life by the blood. Everything that demands that we grow above and subdue under us is accessible by the potency of the blood. And that fears that you have within you, and that troubles that you have within you, and that situation that you perceive as actually surmounting you and putting you under pressure or suppressing you in every area or in any area of your life, I tell you by the mercy of the living God that there is overcoming power in the blood. No devil can stand the blood. The Bible says it's the blood of the everlasting covenant. There is no covenant above that covenant on the cross of Calvary. Meaning, there is nothing that is as potent that can actually stop the agenda of God when the blood is engaged. There is overcoming power in the blood. Can I pray for someone here tonight? That in the name of Jesus, the resurrected Lord, every sudden and untimely death that the enemy has planned for you, by the reason of the blood of Jesus tonight, you are overcoming them. You're not sounding like one that is ready. In the name of Jesus, the resurrected Lord, you are overcoming all of them. I want to pray for one who will receive the biggest miracle tonight, that every ugly situation of your life, by the reason of the blood, you are overcoming them tonight. If I send you a manager, you remember now. Number two, there is embodied power in the Lord. Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 19. He said, having therefore obtained the boldness to enter into the holies by the blood of Jesus, embodying power. I want this. For everybody that the system of this kingdom is actually what made you, one of the things that give you boldness to access the deep things of God is the blood. Until Jesus made his blood, until Jesus became a sacrificial lamb, we could not access the deep things of God. We could not access the holiest city of the living God. So my boldness, so to say, is not an arithmetic that I'm trying to summon or gather. My boldness is a product of the sacrifice of the blood of Christ. I'm so bold. You are so bold. Timidity, fear is taken away simply because of the blood. The Bible said so. In Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 19, he said, having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. So we will not have access into some dimension of victory. You will not have access into dimension of fellowship. We will not have access into the dimension of the things of the Spirit until the blood of Jesus was put upon them. That is to say, boldness to rule over the affairs of life. You see, if you are looking timid in the face of challenges, you can easily be a casualty. I think I have a story to tell you. I used to pray in the night. I stopped for a while because of some few things around me. And in the night, I used to have a walking stick. Because sometimes when you walk too long, you'll be so tired that you need something to support you. So I'll carry my tarpaulin and I begin to play, and then a walking stick with a torchlight. Most times I don't use the torchlight, I put the torchlight right at my back pocket, I play the tarpaulin, and then I carry my walking stick and I begin to walk. So 2 a.m. one night, I was coming out from Dusen. As at exactly 2 a.m., I was getting closer to that bridge that leads to the road to town. Under the bridge, I met a man. He was almost half naked, just tied something around his waist and carried a calabash on his head. And he was murmuring something, and I was praying too. So when I saw him from afar, I increased volume. Shakatokopo, shagadaka. Is my boldness is as a reason of someone who has paid the price. No one carry demon or devils or idols should make me fear. And that is to say, your boldness is rooted in the sacrifice of the blood of the Lamb. When anybody tells you will die young, tell them that Jesus has become a sacrifice for you. And I pray for someone here. Everything subjecting you to fear shall be rooted out of it. Yeah. If I say amen, I don't talk amen with an hour and this. So I face the man and I increase all the matter. The man clear up the road. When he clear up the road, I was laughing. He went forward. He turned back to look at me. He was laughing. But even to some of you, see somebody dressed in one black pants and carry calabash on his head, the kind of run you run. Have you not read Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 19? That he has given us access to enter the holiest of holies. That he has given us the boldness because of the Son. He said, let no one trouble me, for I bear in my body the mark of God. And the blood of Jesus is upon me. The boldness is in no man can stop me. So there is a warning power in the blood. Number three. I told you I want to tell you seven. Number three, there is cleansing power in the blood. Meaning, if there are some of us that are actually dirty, and that is why sudden and untimely death is looking for us, but the blood of Jesus can, it cleanses you. The Bible speaking in 1 John chapter 1, number 7. 1 John chapter 1, number 7, we said, but if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleansed us from all sin. Now, I love this. He said, cleansed us from what?
All sin.
Cleansed us from all. Cleansed us. He didn't say, cleansed us from sin. Some of us have actually fornicated before and we are raped. That is because of my sin. And that's why they want to attack me so that I die young and I do this way. There is a cleansing power. 1 John chapter 1, number 7. 1 John chapter 1, number 7. He said, Bible recorded, he said, if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. Cleanses us from all sin. Cleanses us from all sin. Many of us are afraid you need your sin of the father's house is what is actually wanting you. They said they have actually committed the crime of your father's house, and that's why they die young. I have a good news for you. The blood of Jesus cleanses us from us. Us. Sin of gossiping, sin of rebellion. Then the gay system is everything. You know, you are killing your future. But the blood of Jesus cleanses us from our sin. You know, the good news is this. He said, if many of us all will sit back and then begin to record, we do see him of the things we have done in the past. I smoke, I drink, I pray. I'm not born again. Are you saying God has truly forgiven me? Yes. For whosoever the Son of Man shall send me shall be free. It is total liberty. And how do we come to that realm? He said, whosoever the Son of Man said, we shall be free indeed. The Bible recorded in 1 John chapter 1 and verse 7. He said, the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. Meaning, you are now only before the Lord. You have the right platform to ask him that which you want to ask. Never be afraid of what the devil will do to you. Never be afraid of that bad news they are giving to you. Never ever conform to whatever the devil is saying. Because you are slain as Christians before the Lord. Why? Because of the blood of Jesus. Number four. Can I continue? Is somebody blessed tonight? Number four, there is pacifying power in the blood. Pacifying power in the blood. Colossians chapter 1 and verse 20. Colossians chapter 1, I'm going to explain that to us. Colossians chapter 1. Colossians chapter 1 and verse 20. He said that having made peace through the blood of his cross, to him to reconcile all things unto himself. By him I say, whether there be things in earth or things in heaven. Can tell you about that the reason of the blood of Jesus on the cross of Calvary to move into a realm of peace. When there are troubles around, there are calamities around, the Lord needs to be engaged. Some days ago, where our old church was, that time and then we're there, and in that junction, they used to have bike accidents every morning. The bike accident becomes so terrible, people who stay losing, ask them of give a junction. They know the story. One day I began to pray and I said, this nonsense has to stop. I remember that junction I was praying one night. And I prayed about 3 hours in the morning. Some night I sat down very far. I was some of the ladies who were actually members of this church at that time, before one of them got married, they had a challenge. So they brought the gifts to me because the other lady did not have a place to stay. So we begged the other lady to say, please keep this lady in your house for a while. Since you guys are lady, you are single, you are staying alone, let her stay with you. So it has been troubles upon troubles, troubles upon troubles. So one night around 11 p.m. in the night, so they brought the gifts. They were shouting and shouting, and they know I sleep in church. Knocking the door, and then I came out and then to listen to them. After they talk, I was ready to say to them, all of us were facing the junction. So something from afar looked as if somebody was wearing white and was coming from one side of that junction. And the person got to the middle of the junction and disappeared. The kind of run they run that night. I was just sitting looking at them. And I told them that you know, if you have an idea of what I see here in the night, none of you will stay with me. One young man right just was with me one night, and he said, sir, I was sleeping in church with you. I said, go home. They said, I will stay. Okay. So he said, at about 12:30 that month, a snake passed. I was just sleeping then. Some rats were making noise. I was just sleeping then. We saw one cat. When he saw the cat, he said, sir, if this is what you see in the night, I won't sleep again. But I know from scriptures that we are pacified, nothing by shy any means. But I'm so shielded and protected. I'm an ambassador of peace to declare to every storm, peace is it. You see, until you move to a realm of knowledge, you will never enjoy your Christian work. I tell you. But tonight, the Lord God of heaven will establish peace over your life.
Amen.
You are saying that I thought you know me better than this.
Amen.
The Lord God of heaven I decree every storm around your life, I decree peace be still in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Number 5. Because of time. Because I want us to pray before we go into the section of the anointing. Number 5. There is some inspiring power in the blood. You see, the overcoming power in the blood is what I'm supposed to capitalize on, or maybe to expatiate, but I want to give us a bit of understanding of what we are in, so that you will know the potency of the blood, and that will prepare you to pray. Because maybe one or maybe two or three of us will actually need, or maybe you have a question in your heart and then you are trusting God to answer. And I trust that the Lord will answer the question in your heart. There is some inspiring power in the blood. Revelation chapter 5 and verse 9. For many of us who are struggling to compose songs, for many of the singers who sing nonsense, If you understand the potency of his blood, you will receive inspiration to sin. Let's put that scripture together. Revelation 5:9. Revelation chapter 5, verse 9. And they sang a new song, saying, "Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seal thereof. For thou wast slain and hast redeemed us to God by the blood out of every kingdom and tongues and people and nation." Some never filled their mouths here until the reality and the potency of the blood of Jesus in that one. When the blood is engaged over us, it opened a new door entirely of inspiration to us. It opened a new door of inspiration to us. Maybe there's somebody who needs that kind of anointing tonight. By the reason of the blood of Jesus, maybe some of us, God has been giving your heart for you to sing or something, and then you have not been finding expression. Tonight, the gate is opened by the blood tonight.
Yeah.
Number 6. There is redemption power in the blood. Maybe I'll stop here. Maybe I'll stop here. There is redemption power in the blood. Redeeming power, if you put it that way. Hebrews chapter 5. Sorry, Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 22. Maybe I'll stop here tonight. Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 22. Hebrews 9:22. And almost all things are by blood, purged with blood. And without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. The shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Meaning the blood of Jesus did not come. That was the blood that was shed for the remission of our sin. None of us will actually be redeemed to God. None of us will actually be reconciled to God. Because of the sacrifice of Jesus. But the redeeming power, the redemption power to make us redeemed was actually purchased by the blood. I show you a scripture. Hebrews chapter, sorry, actually Apostles chapter 20 and verse 28. Let me show you this. I just remember the scripture now. Actually Apostles 20. And look about the apostle. Is somebody blessed in it? He said, "Take heed therefore unto yourself and to the flocks over which the Holy Ghost has made you overseers to feed the church of God, which he purchased by what?" Which he purchased by what? Meaning the church is purchased by the blood. We are redeemed people. We are bought with the price, and the price is the blood. Now watch this. If the blood of Jesus actually redeemed you, purchased you, can any devil kill what the blood has purchased? But the challenge is not many of us actually engage that which you have. We don't. Many knowledgeable, so so knowledgeable, but they never engage what the provision of scriptures and the instant of challenge. A young man, my wife was there. We're staying at our house very close to the rock sometimes back. And something happened. There's this family very close to us there. They've been recruited to lead us now. The wife called us around after 11 in the night. He said, "Pastor, I don't understand what is happening. Just come." And I couldn't leave my wife alone in the house that time. I said, "Now you have to follow me." So we went together. Before we got to the place, my wife has fallen down about 2 times. So I knew immediately that what we're going for was serious. When we got to the place, something happened. The wife said he doesn't understand what is happening again. And when I entered the room, I touched the leg of the young man. The leg was cold. I touched his hand. The hand was cold. I called his name. He never answered. The eyes had come back up. The mouth was open. Immediately I knew. And as a pastor trusting God for miracle, there are some things you don't say. I didn't want to say he's dead. My wife entered the room with me that night. I told her, I said, "Will you please stay out?" She obeyed. I told the wife too. I said, "Madam, please, would you stay? This is your room." And I said, "Father, in the name of Jesus." And the Lord said, "Kneel down." And I went on my knees and I said, "Father, in the name of Jesus, dear young man, come back to life." Before I said, "In Jesus' name I pray," he coughed. He sneezed. Sweat all over him. And opened his eyes and he said, "Pastor, I raised him." They sat down. And I called the people that were outside. They never knew what happened. And I said, "Now we'll take him to hospital. Just for hospital sake." On the way when we're going to hospital, none of them, they don't have a car, I don't have a car, so we have to trek. While we're trekking, he told me what happened. He said, going somewhere. I know he's already going to heaven. The Lord returning back to life. But I want to show you a mystery tonight in the brother you went to life. What mystery? Father, in the name of Jesus, I plead the blood of Jesus over me and over everyone here. Dear young man, come back to life. The blood of Jesus is a life-giving blood. Meaning, you cannot die before your time engaging. In your life, in your family, I speak to you right now by the power and the blood of Jesus. I decree you shall not die. Yeah. I can't forget men with louder than this. And I decree in your family, there will be no better than that. Yeah. Every day looking for you by the reason of the blood of Jesus, my dear son, somebody is here tonight. I saw an only child, only child.